Hello, I'm Subponicate Poster, and welcome to Let's Play Dragon Age Inquisition. Well, it's a lovely day for a conclave, so let's go ahead and get started. What could possibly go wrong? Well, at least we survived the explosion. Things don't seem to be going very well for us so far, do they? Couple of familiar faces.
Tell me why we shouldn't kill you now. The conclave is destroyed. Everyone who attended is dead, except for you.
What do you mean everyone's dead?
Explain this.
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I don't know what that is, or how it got there.
You're lying!
We need her, Cassandra.
This is an expansion on the system in Dragon Age 2. You get emotions, happy, sad, confused. We're gonna go with angry, because we didn't do anything.
Whatever you think I did, I'm innocent.
Do you remember what happened? How this began?
I remember running. Things were chasing me, and then a woman?
A woman?
She reached out to me, but then
go to the forward camp, Liliana. I will take her to the rift.
What did happen?
It will be easier to show you.
Well, that doesn't look good.
We call it the Breach. It's a massive rift into the world of demons that grows larger with each passing hour. It's not the only such rift, just the largest. All were caused by the explosion at the Conclave.
An explosion can do that?
This one did. Unless we act, the Breach may grow until it swallows the world. Each time the breach expands, your mark spreads, And it is killing you. It may be the key to stopping this, but there isn't much time.
You say it may be the key. To doing what?
Closing the breach. Whether that's possible is something we shall discover shortly. It is our only chance, however. And yours.
You still think I did this? To myself?
Not intentionally. Something clearly went wrong.
And if I'm not responsible?
Someone is. And you are our only suspect. You wish to prove your innocence? This is the only way.
We're trying to suck up to Cassandra, so we're going with the top option.
I understand.
Then
I'll do what I can. Whatever it takes.
They have decided your guilt. They need it. The people of Haven mourn our most holy, divine Justinia, head of the Chantry. The Conclave was hers. It was a chance for peace between mages and Templars. She brought their leaders together. Now they are dead. We lash out like the sky, but we must think beyond ourselves, as she did. Until the breach is sealed. There will be a trial. I can promise no more. Come. It is not far.
Where are you taking me?
Your mark must be tested on something smaller than the breach.
Okay, so we finally have control of our character for the first time. This is a very big place.
Open the gate. We are heading into the valley.
Maybe as a response to the criticism of Dragon Age 2, BioWare definitely went in the opposite direction. Inquisition is massive. The maps are huge. The world is huge. There's a lot to see and a lot to do.
Pulses are coming faster now. The larger the breach grows, the more rifts appear, the more demons we face.
How did I survive the blast?
They said you stepped out of a rift, then fell unconscious. They say a woman was in the rift behind you. No one knows who she was. Everything farther in the valley was laid waste. Including the Temple of Sacred Ashes. I suppose you'll see soon enough.
Yeah, let's go see. We really cannot catch a break today, Cam.
Stay behind me!
That's convenient. And here's our introduction to combat. So as a rogue, we're going to benefit a lot from flanking and backstabbing.
It's over.
Drop your weapon. Now!
Still sucking up to Cassandra.
All right. Have it your way.
Wait. I cannot protect you. And I cannot expect you to be defenseless. I should remember you agreed to come willingly. Take these potions. Maker knows what we will face.
Where are all your soldiers?
At the forward camp or fighting. We are on our own for now.
Okay, here's our first glance at the inventory screen. I'll just show this off and edit it out otherwise. I don't know why the game decided to give us a second pretty much identical set of armor, but we'll put that on. And our scout hat, which looks stupid, but it gives a little extra protection. You can toggle helmets on and off from the options menu. Unfortunately, you can't select on or off for each party member like you could in the first Mass Effect. We'll be playing with helmets on. Some of them look pretty cool, some of them are kind of dumb, but they're always off in cutscenes.
There! Watch out! If we flank them, we may gain the advantage.
I didn't use the lock on here. It's not always helpful. We're gonna go after the ranged guy up here. He's actually more dangerous than the one down below. That power was Twin Fangs. It does decent damage, but it has a tendency to miss on moving targets. So we probably won't use that too much once we get something better. Unlike Origins in DA2, you don't get the reticle on your target that shows you when you're in a backstab or flanking position, so you kind of have to guess. They've also added a jump button, but the platforming can be a bit unreliable. There's Twin Fangs missing again. Go over here and pick up some loot. Instead of collectible items glowing like they did in the first two games, you have to send out a search pulse on PlayStation 4. That's by pressing L3, and the item will get a highlight around it. It'll also appear on your map, which was added in a patch.
We're getting close to the rift. You can hear the fighting.
Who's fighting?
You'll see soon. We must help them.
Guess we'd better go help out.
Quickly, before more come through.
What did you do?
I did nothing. The credit is yours.
At least this is good for something.
Whatever magic opened the breach in the sky also placed that mark upon your hand. I theorized the mark might be able to close the rifts that have opened in the breach's wake. And it seems I was correct.
Meaning it could also close the breach itself?
Possibly. It seems you hold the key to our salvation.
Good to know. Here I thought we'd be ass deep in demons forever. Barak Tethrys, rogue, storyteller, and occasionally unwelcome tag-along.
Are you with the Chantry, or...?
Was that a serious question?
Technically, I'm a prisoner, just like you.
I brought you here to tell your story to the Divine. Clearly, that is no longer necessary.
Yet, here I am. Lucky for you, considering current events.
It's good to meet you, Varric.
You may reconsider that stance in time.
Oh, I'm sure we'll become great friends in the Valley, Chuckles.
Absolutely not. Your help is appreciated, Varric, but...
Have you been in the Valley lately, Seeker? Your soldiers aren't in control anymore. You need me.
Ugh.
My name is Solas, if there are to be introductions. I am pleased to see you still live.
He means I kept that mark from killing you while you slept.
Solas likes questions, so we're going to gain a little bit of approval here with him.
You seem to know a great deal about it all.
Solas is an apostate, well-versed in such matters.
Technically, all mages are now apostates, Cassandra. My travels have allowed me to learn much of the Fade, far beyond the experience of any Circle mage. I came to offer whatever help I can give with the breach. If it is not closed, we are all doomed, regardless of origin.
That's a commendable attitude.
Merely a sensible one. Although, sense appears to be in short supply right now. Cassandra, you should know. The magic involved here is unlike any I've seen. Your prisoner is no mage. Indeed, I find it difficult to imagine any mage having such power.
Understood. We must get to the forward camp quickly.
Well... Bianca's excited.
Okay, we'll run up here and grab a little bit of loot.
This way, down the bank. The road ahead is blocked.
We must move quickly.
And a new one. Miss me.
Demons ahead.
Glad you brought me now, Seeker.
And here we get our introduction to the tactical camera. It's not as good as it was in the first two games. If you're on uneven ground, it does not path right. The reticle will not pass in a straight line to your target. And the amount of commands that you can give are more limited. I won't be using it very much. It's not necessary on easy or normal. You can button mash your way through the game by spamming regular powers and just using regular attacks. You may want to use it from time to time for sniping or something to that effect, but for the most part, we won't be using it too much. Okay, instead of heading towards our objective, we're going to head to the end of this valley to pick up a little more loot and get some optional conversation. Now you notice that blue bar over my head? That is barrier. And the silver over Cassandra is guard. The healing potions in the game are extremely limited. You start off with 8, the maximum you can carry is 12, and that's for the entire party, not per person. And so barrier and guard are a way of extending your health. You'll have to either burn up the barrier or use up the guard before any damage actually takes off your health. A little money. And an accessory. Okay, and this is gathering resources. This will become very important once we get into crafting, which won't be for a bit yet. It's now a gigantic pain in the ass, also, since they patched out
Dalish,
duping.
But clearly away from the rest of your clan. Did they send you here?
What do you know of the Dalish?
I have wandered many roads in my time, and crossed paths with your people on more than one occasion.
What do you mean by crossed paths?
I mean that I offer to share knowledge. Only to be attacked for no greater reason than their superstition.
Can't you elves just play nice for once?
Head over to this burned out house here for a little more loot. Getting back to crafting, you can pick up minerals, leather, cloth, and herbs. The first three are used for weapons and armor. Herbs are only used for upgrading potions, tonics, and grenades. None of the crafting components take up inventory room. You can pretty much carry infinite amounts of those.
We must hurry before the mark consumes her.
There's a little bit of loot off there to the right behind that wall. I forgot to pick it up.
That'll get you every time. Should have spun a story.
That's what you would have done.
It's more believable and less prone to result in premature execution.
This was me going into the tactical camera, trying to use a power that Cassandra doesn't actually have yet. She'll get that after she levels up. It's an area taunt, generates guard, which is very useful. Now that we have 3 people in our party, things are dying in a tidy manner.
She's resourceful, Seeker.
We will see for ourselves at the forward camp. We're almost there.
Another rift!
We must seal it! Quickly!
They keep coming! Help us!
Now with rifts, there are a couple of actions you can take. You can disrupt the rift, which will stun and damage enemies. Didn't really get this one off before Cassandra took that guy out. Once all the enemies are dead, you can close the rift. This makes it go away, stop spewing demons out, and they do not respawn once they're closed. Ah, and we leveled up. So we'll get into this menu, show you that. Now, like Dragon Age 2, abilities are divided into trees instead of the linear progression we had in Origins. Unlike the first two games, you only have access to 8 powers at a time. You still receive a point every time you level up, but as you progress, you're forced to pick and choose what abilities you want. This was meant to make combat more tactical. Your squad mates will use all the powers they have unlocked when under AI control, but once you switch to them, only mapped abilities are available. Diamonds are active powers, circles are passive. These are buffs and bonuses. Sometimes you'll take a power you don't really want or need to get a useful passive. Here, we're going to take another attack power so that we have a little bit more in our arsenal. Flank attack. And there's the pop-up that you get explaining the difference. Okay, now that we're leveled up, we'll go ahead and move on.
Rift is gone. Open the gate.
Right away, Lady Cassandra.
We are clear for the moment. Well done.
Whatever that thing on your hand is, it's useful.
Now up here on the left is a supply cache. This is how you replenish your potions when you're in a mission. We didn't use any, but if anyone in your party is low on health, have them drink a potion and then go ahead and refill, because it will restock you to whatever your maximum carrying capacity is. And Liliana's made it up here ahead, having a conversation with someone we haven't met that doesn't seem to be going very well. Let's go have a chat with them.
Ah, here they come.
You made it. Chancellor Roderick, this is...
I know who she is. As Grand Chancellor of the Chantry, I hereby order you to take this criminal to Valroyo to face execution.
Order me? You are a glorified clerk, a bureaucrat.
And you are a thug, but a thug who supposedly serves the Chantry.
We serve the Most Holy, Chancellor. As you well know.
Justinia is dead! We must elect a replacement and obey her orders on the matter.
You know, fuck this guy.
Don't talk about me like I'm not here.
You shouldn't even be here! Call a retreat, Seeker. Our position here is hopeless.
We can stop this before it's too late.
How? You won't survive long enough to reach the temple, even with all your soldiers.
We must get to the temple. It's the quickest route.
But not the safest. Our forces can charge as a distraction while we go through the mountains.
We lost contact with an entire squad on that path. It's too risky.
Listen to me. Abandon this now. Before more lives are lost.
How do you think we should proceed?
An orange conversation wheel means that it's a plot critical choice.
Now you're asking me what I
think. You have the mark.
And you are the one we must keep alive. Since we cannot agree on our own,
this option gains approval with Varric, and there's less combat. The option on the left gains approval with Cassandra, and it's a little bit faster. We're going to take that option.
I say we charge. I won't survive long enough for your trial. Whatever happens, happens now. Liliana, bring everyone left in the valley. Everyone.
On your head be the consequences, Seeker.
Well, we're heading off to the Temple of Sacred Ashes to attempt to close the breach. Will we succeed? Find out next time on Let's Play Dragon Age.